Hi students, in today's class some more basic points we will discuss. That is, first we will see all these ratios and proportions, and then we will start a very important topic and which will be very useful for us in throughout our JE course, that is logarithms. Okay, we will start. First we will write some identities which all of you must be knowing all these, but still we have to write once. A plus b whole square, it is a square plus b square plus 2ab, all of you know this. A minus b whole square, a square plus b square minus 2ab. If you take addition of these two, a plus b whole square plus a minus b whole square, it is 2 times of a square plus b square. Just add these two. Subtract these two, a plus b whole square minus of a minus b whole square, it will become 4ab. And of course, if I take a minus b whole square minus of a plus b whole square minus 4ab, that I am not writing here. A square minus b square, you know that factors are a plus b into a minus b. And next, a plus b whole cube, it is a cube plus 3 a square b plus 3 a b square plus b cube. These are the, expansion of a plus b whole cube. It is equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b also I can write. Yes, I wrote these two and I have taken 3ab common a plus b. Therefore, from this sometimes we may require to write a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b whole cube minus 3ab of a plus b. And next, a cube plus b cube factors a plus b into a square minus a b plus b square. We will be using many times this formula. Factors for a cube plus b cube, a plus b into a square minus a b plus b square. We will be using many times this one. And the next, seventh one, a minus b whole cube, it is equal to a cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square minus b cube. And this can be written as a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. I have written a cube minus b cube, and from these two minus 3ab common a minus b. Next, this a cube minus b cube can be written as a minus b whole cube plus 3ab into a minus b also. And next, once again, factors for this a cube minus b cube, a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. Even this one also very important formula. Factors for a cube plus b cube, a plus b into a square minus a b plus b square. Factors for a cube minus b cube, a minus b into a square plus a b plus b square. And next, coming to next one, a plus c whole square, a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. And of course, this can also be written as a square plus b square plus c square. I will take 2abc common, it is 1 by c plus 1 by a plus 1 by b, we can write. Yes, sometimes may be required to take this in this form. 1 by a plus 1 by b plus 1 by c. And next, one more result we will be using this one also frequently. A square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca can be written as half of a minus b whole square plus b minus c whole square plus c minus a whole square. While finding domain, while observing triangle is equilateral or not, many times, please remember this always. A square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca can be written as half of a minus b whole square plus b minus c whole square plus c minus a whole square. I will explain you. This actually what I am doing, multiply and divide with 2. It is 2a square, it is 2b square, it is 2c square, minus 2ab, minus 2bc, minus 2ca. This 2a square, I will write it as a square plus a square. This 2b square can be written as a b square plus b square. 2c square can be written as c square plus c square. Here minus 2ab in terms of ab is there, a square, b square and minus 2ab one term. And minus 2bc is there, b square, c square and this minus 2bc term. It is a minus b whole square, it is a b minus c whole square and leftover terms a square plus c square minus 2ca, that is c minus a whole square, that 1 by 2 is there outside. That is a way how we can write that one. Anyhow, now I will rub this one and I will write one more formula. Next, a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc factors a plus c into a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus c. Factors for this are a plus c into a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca. Yes, observe this one. This one only. So, this can also be written as a plus c by 2 into a minus b whole square plus b minus c whole square plus c minus a whole square. A plus c by 2 into a minus b whole square plus b minus. This can be written as 1 by 2 into that 1 by 2 I wrote here, it is whole square. And of course, here if a plus c equal to 0, it is equal to 0 means total this value equal to 0. In that case, what will happen? You see, a cube plus b cube plus c cube will become 3abc. One more point extension. You all know this, I think. A plus c equal to 0 implies a cube plus b cube plus c cube equal to 3abc. And factors for this are this one. And a plus c equal to 0 means a cube plus c cube equal to 3abc. And one more, if I take an expression of the form x power 4 plus x square plus 1, important, writing factors for this one. This I am writing it as x power 4 plus 2x square plus 1 minus x square I am writing. See what I did? I have just added x square and subtracted x square. And factors for this are there, x square plus 1 whole square, completing square. It is x square plus 1 whole square minus x square. Now it is of the form a square minus b square. It is equal to x square plus x plus 1 into x square minus x plus 1. Yes. Factors for x power 4 plus x square plus 1 are x square plus x plus 1 into x square minus x plus 1. You must remember this one also. All looks like very simple only, but our problems, almost all problems, we will come across at least any one of these always. So, please practice this Don't think that all these we studied in 10th class or 8th class or lower classes. Once again, you go through all these, and one must remember all these results, and we will be using these many times. Let us see this ratio and proportion also we will see. Suppose if you take A and B are two quantities of same kind, then their ratio is A is to B, which may be denoted by the fraction A by B. And in lower classes you learned this. Some points are there, I will write. Next, two points you see, you knew these points already. If A is to B is any ratio, then its duplicate ratio is A square is to B square, A cube triplicate ratio is A cube is to B cube, and so on. And if A is to B is any ratio, then its subduplicate ratio is A power 1 by 2 is to B power 1 by 2, and subtriplicate ratio is A power 1 by 3 is to B power 1 by 3, and so on. We will see proportions. When two ratios are equal, that is, if A, B, C, D are any four real numbers such that A is to B is equal to C is to D, then these four numbers are said to be proportional. That is, you see, when two ratios are equal, then the four quantities compositing them are said to be proportional. And whenever A by B equal to C by D, then it is written as A is to B equal to C is to D. Now, we will see some properties related to this. This B and C are called means, A and D are called extremes. See here, A and B are known as extremes, and B and C are known as means. And of course, product of these means is equal to product of these extremes. Therefore, product of extremes is equal to product of, you have used many times in lower classes. Now, whenever A is to B equal to C is to D, then B is to A is equal to D is to D, then this property is known as invertendo. And next, A is to B equal to C is to D, then A is to C is equal to B is to D, then it is called alternando. Alternando means ratio can be taken in this form. Both are same only. That is, A is to B means, you see, A by B equal to C by D. This can also be written as A by C is equal to B by D also. This and this. But when you write that one, that ratio from this ratio is known as alternando. What is componendo is, A by B equal to C by D can be written as A by B plus 1 is equal to C by D plus 1. Ratio, no, I can add 1 on both sides. Now, this is A plus B by B is equal to C plus D by D. Yes. See, whenever A is to B equal to C is to D, then A plus B by B equal to C plus D by D. A plus B by B equal to, this is called componendo. And similarly for this ratio, I will take minus 1 for this, that is A minus B by B is equal to C minus D by D. This ratio is called dividendo. Whenever A is to B equal to C is to D, then A minus B by B equal to C minus D by D, it is called dividendo. And now, if I divide these, A plus B by A minus B equal to C plus D by C minus D. Whenever A is to B is equal to C is to D, then A plus B by A minus B equal to C plus D by C minus D is called componendo and dividendo. And you see this one we will be using in our, problems. Whenever A is to B equal to C is to D, then we will apply componendo and dividendo. I can write it as A plus B by A minus B equal to C plus D by C minus D. That is, a by b equal to c by d can be written as a plus b by a minus b equal to c. Very useful this result. For this one only we are learning all this. A plus b by a minus b equal to c plus d by c minus d. All these you know already. And next, whenever these ratios a by b equal to c by d equal to e by f and so on, then each ratio is equal to sum of all the numerators by sum of all the denominators. A plus c plus e plus and so on by b plus d plus f plus and so on. And one more point, a by b equal to c by d equal to e by f and so on, then each is equal to, I will multiply both numerator and denominator with x, multiply both numerator and denominator with y, z, x a by x b, y c by y d, z e by z f. By using this property, I can add all those x a plus y c plus z e plus and so on by x b plus y d plus z f plus and so on. That is, each is equal to this, then ratio will not change. These are very basic points, but you must have knowledge about this one. Mostly this one, when a by b equal to c by d, component or dividend, if you apply, a plus b by a minus b can be written as c plus d by c minus d. While doing many problems, we will be using this one. Okay, next we will move to logarithms, which is a very important topic for us. Suppose n and a not equal to 1 be any two positive real numbers. Observe this definition. Capital N and a not equal to 1 be any two positive real numbers. Positive real numbers means, you know, R plus. R plus means it is nothing but open 0 to infinity. It is not equal to 0, real numbers open 0 to infinity. And x is any other real number. X is any real number such that if these three are connected by a relation n equal to a power x, then this x is said to be logarithm of n to the base a. Definition only, observe carefully. N a not equal to 1 be any two positive real numbers and x is any real number. So, sir, n is equal to a power x, then this x can be written as, or x is said to be logarithm of n to the base a. It is what? Base, and it is the number, value of this is equal to x. Observe here. X is a real number, n should be positive real number, a also positive real number but should not be equal to 1. N positive real numbers, a also real number, positive real number only, and of course it should not be equal to 1. If it is equal to 1, it is not defined. That is, a base of the logarithm should not be equal to 1. Then this x is equal to, means x can be any real number here. It is what definition for this. Suppose if I take 8, can be written as a 2 cube. Is it in the form n equal to a power x? Yes, because it is of the form n equal to a power x, therefore 3 can be written as log 8 to the base 2. Log 8 to the base 2. And if I take 64, if I take, yes, I can write 4 cube. Therefore, log 64 to the base 4 is equal to 3. Or 64 can be written as 8 square, therefore 2 can be written as log 64 to the base 8. Therefore, whenever it is n equal to a power x, that x is said to be logarithm of n to the base a, x is equal to log n to the base a. So, observe here carefully. Suppose if I take log n to the base a, or it may be whatever it is, log b to the base a, whatever it is. It is the logarithm function, and what are the values I can substitute for this n r plus? The values where I can substitute for any function is called domain. I think you might have heard about the word domain. Domain of any function is nothing but values of x where that function is defined, is called domain. What are the values that you can substitute here? Only positive real numbers. Therefore, I can say domain of this logarithmic function is r plus, that is nothing but open 0 to infinity. And next, what are the values that it will take? Already we have seen x. What is x? X is any real number, means x belong to R. After substituting values of this n, we are getting all numbers. It may be positive or negative, whatever it is. One second here, listen. Suppose if I take 1 by 8, can be written as 2 power minus 3. 1 by 8 is equal to 2 power minus 3 means, therefore, minus 3 is equal to log 1 by 8 to the base 2. Observe this. Here it is a positive number only, and it is not equal to 1 positive number. What is the value of this? It is equal to minus 3. Therefore, even you will get negative number also. That is what I while defining this one, x is any real number I have given. Therefore, when you substitute the values for n, you will get these values x. And this x may be positive, negative, all you are getting means r. And these values are called range of that function. Therefore, what is a range of this logarithmic function? You can write a range complete R means minus infinity comma infinity you will get. Any function if you take y equal to f of x, of course, complete in detail we will be doing in the chapter called functions, but basic knowledge we want. What is a domain and what is a range? What is a domain? Domain of any function is nothing but the value of x, if f of x is the function. If f of x is the function, y equal to f of x is the function if you take, the values of x where that function is defined is called domain. And the moment you substitute all these domain values, it is giving values in output. All these values are called range of that function. Therefore, here log n to the base a, if you take, it is the logarithmic function. For what values of this n? It is defined only for positive real numbers, means domain is r plus, that is 0 comma infinity. And what are the values this logarithmic function will give? X. X is any real number, therefore, range of this logarithmic function is r, that is minus infinity to infinity. Whatever the function we are studying means, we must have knowledge about domain and range of that function. Okay, it is what basic definition of this logarithmic function. Okay, we will move to next properties. Observe here. Here it is log 64 to the base 4. What is the value? I got 3. Here it is log 64 to the base 8. What is the value? 2. Logarithm of same number only, 64 and 64, but different basis, therefore different values. That is logarithm of x to the base a and logarithm of x to the base b, if these two bases are different, a not equal to b, then they are not equal. therefore you observe log x to the base a and log y to the base a to the same base if they are equal implies x must be equal to y. If you remember this point also, log x to the base a is equal to log y to the base a to the same base means x equal to y. Or whenever two numbers are equal, and if I mean equal means they are positive, then only it is defined, then logarithm of x to the base a is equal to logarithm of y to the base a, to any base we can take. We will see some properties, basic properties of these logarithms. First one, logarithm of 1 to any base is equal to 0. If you take logarithm of 1 to any base, of course here base, whenever if I write log a to the base b or log x to the base y, it is understood that they satisfy the properties to define that function. Here if I take, what are the properties? A must be a positive real number, b must be a positive real number, and b not equal to 1. If I take log x to the base y means, what is the meaning? They satisfy the basics of this one properties. X must be a positive real number, y must be a positive real number, because y is the base, y not equal to 1. Therefore, here also log 1 to the base a is equal to 1, log 1 to any base which is not equal to 1. How this one? Let us see. If I take 1, can be written as a power 0, anything power 0 is equal to 1. Now, is it in the form n is equal to a power x or not? Our basic definition, whenever n equal to a power x, therefore x is said to be logarithm of n to the base a only, because it is of that form n equal to a power x, 0 is equal to log 1 to the base a, hence therefore logarithm of 1 to any base is equal to 0. And next, second one, logarithm of a number to the same base is equal to 1, that is log a to the base a equal to 1. How to prove this one? You see, we will take a can be written as a power 1, clearly it is of the form n equal to a power x. N equal to a power x means x is equal to, x means what is x here? That is 1 is equal to log a to the base a, that is all. Logarithm of any number to the same base is equal to 1. Logarithm of 1 to any base is equal to 0. For example, if I take log 1 to 250 base is equal to 0. Or if I take for this one, log 10 to the base 10 is equal to 1. Or log 3 to the base 3, if I take it, is equal to 1. All logarithm of any number to the same base. Of course, base positive real number, not equal to 1, it is defined and it is equal to. Next, third one, we will see, note these 2 points. Next, third one, log xy to the base a is equal to log x to the base a plus log y to the base a, where x positive, y positive, a positive and not equal to 1. I mean these 3 should be defined first. That is a very important result we will be using many times. Product rule, we can say log of xy is equal to log x to the base a plus log y to the base a. How to prove this one? See this, let log xy to the base a is equal to, I will take m, and log x to the base a is equal to, I will take p, log y to the base a is equal to, I will take q. Observe this, log xy to the base a equal to m implies xy can be written as a power m. Observe this. If n is equal to a power x, what is x? X is said to be logarithm of n to the base a. It is the basic definition. Always you must remember this so that you can prove all these. N equal to a power x, x equal to log n to the base a. Whenever log n to the base a equal to x means n is equal to a power x only. Therefore, here also log n to the base a equal to x, n equal to a power x, that is all, x y equal to a power n. Similarly, log x to the base a equal to p implies I can write x is equal to a power p. Log y to the base a equal to q implies I can write y equal to a power q. That is all. Therefore, now if I take a power m, what is a power m? X y can be written as, what is x? A power p, and what is y? A power q. It is equal to a power p plus q. That implies a power m equal to a power p plus q means m is equal to p plus q. What is m? This product, log x y to the base a is equal to log x to the base a plus log y to the base a. It is the proof for that one. Therefore, log xy to the base a equal to log x to the base a plus log y to the base a. Hope you understood this one. One more result I will show you, because it is also similar model, fourth one. Log x by y to the base a is equal to log x to the base a minus log y to the base a, and x comma y comma a have usual meanings where all these three functions are defined. Here it is product, there it is quotient, log x by y. Whenever it is, quotient means this that can be written as log x to the base a minus log y to the base a. Now, exactly like this only, I will take, let log x by y to the base a is equal to m. Log x to the base a is equal to p. Log y to the base a is equal to q. Observe this. It is by using that concept only, definition, x by y is equal to a power m, and x is equal to a power p, and y is equal to a power q. Therefore, if I take a power m here, what is a power m? X by y is equal to a power p by a power q. What is a power p by a power q? It is equal to a power p minus q. Therefore, a power m equal to a power p minus q means m equal to p minus q. What is m? M means log x by y to the base a equal to p. It is log x to the base a minus log y to the base a. It is the result. Therefore, product log x y to the base a equal to log x to the base a plus log y to the base a. Log x by y to the base a equal to log x by a to base a minus log y to the base a. And these are the proofs for that. Hope you understood. Make a note of these two. Of course, for this you can take generalization also, means log x1 into x2 into x3 and so on xn to the base a is there, can be written as log x1 to the base a plus log x2 to the base a plus and so on plus log xn to the base a also you can. Next result, log x power m to the base a is equal to m times log x to the base a. Add one more, log x to base a power n is equal to 1 by time n times log x to the base a. And one more, log x power m to the base a power n is equal to m by n into log x to the base a. Log x power m to the base a, m log x to the base a, log x to the base a power n, 1 by n log x to the base a, log x power m to the base a power m is a power n is equal to m by n into log x to the base a, right? Let us see this. I will take log x power m to the base a is equal to p, and log x to the base a is equal to q. By using definition, log n to the base a equal to x implies x power m is equal to a power p, and here also by using definition x is equal to a power q. This x value I will just replace here. A power q whole power m is equal to a power p, or that implies a power m q is equal to a power p, that is p is equal to m q. What is p? P is log x power m to the base a is equal to m times. What is q? It is log x to the base a, that's all. This is the result. Log x power m to the base a is equal to m log x to the base a. And similarly, we can write that also. If I take this one, I don't think this proof required, but anyhow, log x to the base a power n is equal to p, log x to the base a is equal to q. Here what I will get, x is equal to a power n whole power p, or x is equal to a power n p I will get, and here x is equal to a power q, that implies n p is equal to q, or that implies p is equal to 1 by n into q. Therefore, what is p? Log x to the base a power n is equal to 1 by n into log x to the base a, that's all. This is the result. And from these two, third one follows. Hope you understood. Now you see, for this, suppose I want log 8 to the base 2 value. This 8 can be written as log of 2 cube to the base 2. It is of the form log x power m to the base a. This 3 I can write here. It is 3 times log 2 to the base 2. Here it is logarithm of a number to the same base. It is equal to 1. It is equal to 3 I can. And for this you see, suppose it is log 2 to the base 16 if it is there. Yes, I can write log 2 to the base 2 power 4. It is of the form log a x to the base a power n. It is equal to 1 by 4 log 2 to the base 2. What is log 2 to the base 2? 1. It is equal to 1 by 4 I can write. And third one, you see, it is the property, you remember, log x power m to the base a power m equal to m by n log x to the base a. Suppose if it is log 16 to the base 32 is there, if I want value of this, what I will do, you see, it is equal to log, it is 2 power 4 by 2 power 5 I can write. It is of the form x power m to the base a power n m by n. This is here and here it is. It is equal to 4 by 5 into log 2 to the base 2. What is log 2 to the base 2? 1. It is equal to 4 by 5 into 1 is equal to 4 by 5. Hope you understood all these three results. Simple results only. Please make a note of all these. Next property, a power log x to the base a is equal to x. How this one? Let us see. I will take a power log x to the base a is equal to p. Clearly, it is of the form n equal to a power x. N equal to a power x means x means log x to the base a is equal to log p to the base a. bases are equal implies their numbers are equal, that is x is equal to p. What is p? P is nothing but a power log x to the base a is equal to x, that's all. Therefore, a power log x to the base a, here it is a, here it is a, means this value is equal to x of t. And next, one more property, x power log y to the base a can be written as y power log x to the base a, very important result. X power log y to the base a is equal to y power log x to the base a. What I did, you see, this x and y are interchanged. Yes, we can interchange. How? That one we will see. I will take x power log y to the base a. This I am writing it as x power log y to the base x into log x to the base a. Base change rule. Log y to the base x into log x to the base a is nothing but log y to the base a only. Here base change rule, what is base change rule? If it is log a to the base b, can be written as log a to the base x into log x to the base b, I can write. Therefore, here log y to the base a can be written as log y to the base x into log x to the base a. Now, it is of the form a power mn. Can be written as x power log y to the base x whole power log x to the base a. A power mn can be written as a power m whole power n. Now, if you observe, here it is x, therefore, by using this property, a and a means value of this is x only, here x and x means value of this is y only, it is equal to y power log x to the base a. Therefore, x power log y to the base a is equal to y power log x to the base a. One has to remember this result. Very important result. So, what are the properties we discussed? You see, once I will write all these. First one, n comma a not equal to 1. Or any two positive real numbers and x is any real number such that n is equal to a power x implies x is said to be log of m of n to the base a. It is a definition. Second point, if I take f of x is equal to log x to the base a, for this domain is R plus, means 0 to infinity, and range complete real numbers minus infinity to infinity. You have to, know this point. Logarithmic function, if you take here, this x and this x are not same. I have taken function defined as log x to the base a, and here it is log n to the base a is the function, here log x to the base a. Domain R plus 0 to infinity and range is R. And third one, whenever log x to the base a is equal to log y to the base a implies x is equal to y. And next, logarithm of same number to the different bases are unequal, that also we have seen. Log 64 to the base 8 and log 64 to the base 4. What is the value of this? 2, 8 square we can write, and here 4 cube I can write, value equal to 3. Therefore, these two are not equal. And next, fifth property, and here all these log product rule, xy to the base a is equal to log x to the base a plus log y to the base a. And sixth one, log x by y to the base a is equal to log x to the base a minus log y to the base a. And seventh, and of course generalization will be there, logarithm of 1 to any base is equal to 0, logarithm of a to base a is equal to 1. And next, eighth one, log x power m to the base a is equal to m log x to the base a. And ninth one, log x to a power n is equal to 1 by n log x to the base a. And tenth one, log x power m to the base a power n is equal to m by n into log x to the base a. And 11th property, if you see base change rule, log a to the base b is equal to 1 by log b to the base a, I can write. And from here only, log a to the base b can be written as log a to the base x into log x to the base b, or log a to the base x by log b to the base x also I can write. You must remember that. And at 12th one, a power log x to the base a is equal to x. And next one, x power log y to the base a can be written as y power log x to the base a. These are the properties we discussed. And please make a note of all these. One has to remember all these properties. There are two types of logarithms we are using. One is common logarithm and other one is natural logarithm. What is a common logarithm? Logarithms defined to the base 10 are called common logarithms or Briggs logarithms. That is, if I take log x to the base 10, it is a common logarithm, or Briggs logarithm we call it as. And logarithms are defined to the base e are called natural logarithms or Napier's logarithms. And it is, suppose log x to the base e means it is Napier's logarithm. Sometimes they will be writing it as ln x indicates to the base e. Therefore, logarithms are two types. One is common logarithms or Briggs logarithms, which are defined to the base 10. And other one is natural logarithms or Napier's logarithms, which are defined to the base e. Now, let us look at graph of this logarithmic function, because that graph is very important for us while doing some problems. I will take f of x is equal to log x to the base. Observe this. Here depends on this base a, different graphs are there for this. When a greater than, we will see, and here f of x is equal to log x to the base a. When 0 less than a less than 1, we will see these two are the graphs. And observe this here, what is the domain of this function? Open 0 to infinity. Either a greater than 1 or 0 less than a less than 1, domain is same only for the logarithmic function. Observe this. If I take here it is 1, log 1 equal to 0, and as values are increasing, the value of function also increasing. And if I take values which are less than 1, because here it is greater than 1, this graph will look like this. It is the graph of this logarithmic function. It is what f of x is equal to log x to the base a, and where a greater than 1, it is the logarithmic function. At x equal to 1, it is equal to 0,
and you observe it will cover complete y axis, means range minus infinity to plus infinity. Look here, suppose my function, if I take f of x equal to log x to the base 2, 2 is greater than 1 only base. Now all positive values, negative values, everything I will get. Suppose if I take x is equal to 4, what is the value I will get? Log 4 to the base 2 is equal to 2. If I take 32, what is the value I will get? Log 32, if I take 2 power 5 to the base 2 means 5. If I take x is equal to 1 by 4, what I will get? You see, log 1 by 4 to the base 2, it is equal to log 2 power minus 2 to the base 2 is equal to minus 2. Means between 0 comma 1, any value if I take, it will be negative only. That's why it is the negative side and it will be this. And you don't have knowledge about this, graph. It will look like this. This function is called increasing function. What is this increasing function means? If I take x1 here, x2 here, just observe this. X2 is greater than that of x1, or x1 less than x2. Function value at x equal to 1 means this is f of x1, and at x2 means what is the value of the function? It is what? F of x2. As values of x increasing, function value also increasing, means that function is called increasing function. That is, whenever x1 less than x2 implies function value for x1 is less than function value for x2, for all x1 comma x2 in that domain, means we can say it is an increasing function. Therefore, f of x equal to log x to the base a, when a greater than 1 means it is increasing function. Graph this one you have to remember, and it is an increasing function, and whenever x1 less than x2 means f of x1 less than f of x2. The moment if you look at base, if it is greater than 1, it is increasing function, this will satisfy this property. In JE questions based on this concept they asked earlier. There is no separate topic for us as logarithms. Therefore, this knowledge is essential for us. These are a basic concept. They can ask, any question on this. We cannot claim logarithms is not there. These are the basics. It is a part of our syllabus only. We have to think in that way. And next, when you take log x to the base a, when 0 less than a less than 1, see this. 0 less than a less than 1 means it is of the form log x to the base 1 by 2 type. Yes, base should be positive and not equal to 1, between 0 to 1 it is. Now, graph of this logarithm if I take, anyhow, whatever the base if you take other than 1, it is always 0 only at x equal to 1. And between 0 comma 1 if you take it is positive, and greater than 1 if you take it is negative, graph of this log x to the base a when 0 less than a less than 1 looks like this. You observe any value you take, suppose in that x is equal to 1 by 2, if I take what I will get? Log 1 by 2 to base 1 by 2 is equal to 1. 1 by 2 means somewhere here it is positive. Suppose if I take somewhere here it is 16 is there, if I take what I will get? X equal to 16 means log 16 to the base 1 by 2 means 2 power minus 1, 16 can be written as it is a 2 power 4 to the base 2 power minus 1. It is by using that one of the property we discuss, 2 to the base 2, it is equal to minus 4. Minus 4 means somewhere here it is minus 4, here it is 1. Therefore, whenever base lies between 0 to 1, whatever the value you take between 0 to 1, it is always positive.
and the value which is greater than x, I mean 1, if you take value is negative. This is the function graph, and you observe it is a decreasing function. Means if I take x1 here, x2 here, this is f of x1 and it is f of x2. Or here if I take x1 and here if I take x2, it is what x1 and it is what f of x2. Here also x1 less than x2 only, but if you see function value at x1 is greater than that of f of x2, the moment if you apply f, f of x1 is greater than that of f of x2 for all x1 comma x2 belong to domain of that function. D denotes domain. So it is for decreasing function, it is for increasing function. Yes, better if you put this it in one box. It is increasing function, it is a decreasing function. So in logarithms, we are dealing with logarithms, means we must know where it is increasing, where it is decreasing. Where it is increasing when base greater than 1, where it is decreasing when base lies between 0 to 1. Increasing means x1 less than x2 means even if you apply that function, that inequality will remain same. X1 less than x2 implies f of x1 less than f of x2 only. And decreasing means whenever x1 less than x2, if you apply that function f of x1 and f of x2, this f of x1 greater than that of f of x2 because of this graph. So graph of f of x equal to log x to the base a looks like this. A greater than 1 means it is the graph. Of course, at x equal to 1 both are 0 only, and 0 less than a less than 1 means it is the graph. Hope you understood. Today we have seen very important prerequisite properties. All those identities we have seen first, a plus b whole square, a minus b whole square, a plus b whole cube, a cube plus b cube, all those are very important results only for us. And next, ratio and proportion. What is componendo and dividendo, mainly for that only we have seen. When a by b equal to c by d implies a plus b by a minus b equal to c plus d by c minus d. And next, logarithms, one of the very important, concept for us, which will not be there in our actual syllabus, but we want knowledge of that one. Today we have seen, we have defined what is the definition of that one, and what is the domain and range of that logarithmic function, and properties of that logarithmic function in detail we have discussed. And in the next lecture, we will be doing, and even that graphs of that logarithm function also we have seen. Types of logarithms, what are natural logarithms, what are common logarithms we have seen, and graphs of those logarithms also we have seen. Graph depends on base only. That is, when a greater than 1 means increasing function, 0 less than a less than 1 means it is a decreasing function we have seen, and all the properties we have discussed today. And you please go through all these properties. Looks very simple only, but very important for us. And in the next lecture, we will be doing problems on that. Till then, take care, all the best, and thank you.